Walt Disney Pictures presents an all-new animated film. If you feel
lost, I've got a mama. Don't you have a family somewhere too?
Discover the adventure.
A family full of tiggers. Can you imagine such a thing?
And believe in your imagination.
You can't help me find Tigger. It's all my fault.
With Roo.
Only the best for my bestest little brother.
Eeyore, Piglet, Tigger, and Winnie the Pooh. Own the Tigger movie.
We're always there for you.
Walt Disney had a special gift for taking classic stories with memorable characters and turning them into magical movies. And just as he gave life to Cinderella and Pinocchio, he created a feature film based on a story that held a special place in his heart. And now three of Disney's best-loved tales can be seen in their original format and become part of every family's collection of great Disney animated classics, The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh. So join Christopher Robin and his best friend Pooh in a wonderful collection of adventures in 100 Acre Wood. In the original Winnie the Pooh feature film. Carefully restored to its original brilliance. The Many Adventures of Winnie the Pooh.
Humming a melody.
Could it be Who Dare?
Maybe it's Pooh Bear.
Pooh? Well, that's me.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
Come and find me.
He's Winnie the Pooh. He's in the book. He's Winnie the Pooh.
Your name remind me.
Everyone knows he's Winnie the Pooh.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
And all my friends here.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
Come have a look.
He's Winnie the Pooh.
The fun never ends here.
Everyone knows.
It was a lovely day, and Christopher Robin had just returned from school, and he was ready to... that's strange. Christopher Robin, are you there? Oh, how embarrassing. I wonder where it could be.
Oh, Christopher Robin!
Where could he be?
Well, he should be here by now. School lets out at 3, as I remember it.
Well, everyone, I hate to disappoint you, but I don't think Christopher Robin has arrived home yet.
Oh, bother. And I was really hoping he might read us a story.
Hey, I got an idea. Maybe if we find Christopher Robin's little bookie thing that he writes stuff down in...
Bookie thing?
I think Tigger means Christopher Robin's journal, Pooh.
Oh, yes, of course. It's journal. But what is a journal, if I may ask?
Oh, well, a journal is a book in which you write daily entries about things that happen to you. You can also doodle in a journal, or just write down your thoughts or feelings.
Yeah, that. And if I could just find it, we'll look up today.
And we'll be able to see what's happening to Christopher Robin right now. What a wonderful idea, Tigger.
Well, Tigger, Pooh, you know, I'm not sure that's how a journal works.
Oh, yes. I'm not at all sure that's right either.
Okay, let me...
Yes.
Oh, here it is.
Oh, look at Pooh, Tigger. Look! That looks like me.
Well, I think it is you, Piglet. It seems that Christopher Robin has marked his favorite stories about each one of his friends with bookmarks.
Oh, that's us.
Oh, that's very nice.
Oh, I can't wait to hear a story, Piglet. I do wish Christopher Robin would get here.
Well, Mr. Narrator, do you think Christopher Robin would mind if we read a few stories while we're waiting?
Well, I don't think he would mind.
Then I think we should read the one about Pooh first, seeing as he's the very first one who wanted to hear a story.
All right. Since Pooh was the first one who wanted to hear a story, we'll read a story about Pooh. Oh, my, yes. This is a good one. One day in the 100-acre wood, Owl was reading a book about the great adventures of his Uncle Waldo.
And so, as the sun set over the hill, Uncle Waldo flew off, ending yet another great adventure.
Oh, my. That was a wonderful story, Owl.
And a great adventure, too.
Yes, it was. A great adventure. Whew. It certainly would be wonderful to have an adventure of my own.
Well, Owl, how do you find an adventure?
Let's see. I'd say there's at least one adventure over every hill.
Wow.
How beautiful. I am very determined, little Piglet, to find an adventure. I guess it's time to go over that hill to look for one. Would you like to come with me, Piglet?
Over the hill? Oh, my. That sounds so very far away. And for certain, if you have to go over the hill, you have to come back, which is even further.
I understand, friend Piglet. So I will be sure to tell you all about my adventure when I return.
Oh, that would be wonderful, Pooh. And while you're gone, Pooh, I'll make a welcome home, Pooh, sign for you. And I'll be right here when you come back.
Wonderful. Oh, it's so nice to have a good friend like you when you're an adventurer like myself. So long, Piglet. I shall see you when I return.
So long, Pooh.
And so our brave friend Winnie the Pooh began walking toward the hill, looking for adventure.
Hello, Rabbit. I'm off on an adventure. Would you like to come?
Sorry, Pooh Bear. I'm too busy with my garden. Have fun.
Thank you, Rabbit. I will. Tigger, would you like to go on an adventure?
No thanks, buddy boy. I'm busy practicing my most tiggerific bounces. This time, I'm going for quality instead of quantity.
I understand, Tigger. I'll be sure to tell you about my adventure after I have it.
I look forward to hearing about it, Pooh, old buddy boy. Abyssinia!
Well, it looks like this is a special adventure just for me.
It's time for adventure. I'm off on an adventure. I know it's out there waiting for a poo. I'm ready and I'm willing for a trip that's thrilling, though I'm not exactly sure what I should do. There are mountains calling and waters waterfalling. Now I just need to figure out the way. I'll run and hike and climb, cause it's the perfect time for adventuring. And oh, it's wonderful, this feeling as I'm marching forth. But oh, how bothersome to never know which way is south and which is north. The world is inviting, it all seems so exciting. So tally-ho, or is it tally-hey? The streams and rivers flowing, so I must be going. Adventuring, adventuring, adventuring. Adventuring today.
So Pooh kept walking and walking and walking until he came to the very hill he had seen outside Owl's house.
Oh my! Look at that beautiful butterfly. I wonder if this is the beginning of my adventure. I certainly hope so. Oh, little butterfly.
So Pooh chased the butterfly, and it spun him around so very much that he became very confused.
Oh, bother. Now let me see. Which way did I come from, and which way should I go to? Well, this way looks very adventurous.
So Pooh set off down the hill again. It really was the way he came, but our good friend Pooh didn't know that.
Whee! Well, look at that. Why, that little bird over there reminds me of my friend Cassie. I'll be sure to tell her about seeing a bird just like her when I return.
Well, you can hop, can't you?
Look, over there, the inhabitants of this strange and beautiful land. I think they look a little familiar.
Dynamics. Well, see, you bend your kneesies, and that's where you get the spring, say.
I see.
Oh, hello. Excuse me, strangers. My name is Pooh, and I am a bear from over the hill, you see. And I was just wondering, what sort of adventures are you up to today?
The bear from over the hill. You don't say.
Are you sure about that?
Don't you live here?
Yes. Aren't you Pooh Bear?
Well, you must be thinking of another Pooh Bear, I'm afraid. You see, I've just walked a long, long way from the other side of the hill, so I couldn't possibly be the Pooh you're thinking of. Although he does sound like a nice enough fellow. I understand your confusion completely. You know, we have creatures like yourselves where I come from, too. In fact, my very dear friends from the other side of the hill look very much like you.
Really? There's a rabbit just like me on the other side of the hill? What's he like? Does he have a garden? Is it as beautiful as mine?
And there's another bluebird like me? How high does she fly? I would love to meet her.
Pooh, how are you doing?
Oh, Owl, this isn't our Pooh Bear.
Yeah, see, this is a new Pooh Bear from over the hill there.
Huh? Oh, really? Oh, my, so sorry to assume. It is very nice to meet you. The resemblance is uncanny.
Two Pooh Bears. Sounds pretty confusing, but one last name to remember, I guess. Nice to meet you.
And nice to meet all of you, too. You know, this is really an unusual adventure. And what a wonderful time I'm having. Except for the rumbling in my tumbly.
Oh, yes. Our friend Pooh Bear from this side of the hill likes honey, too, in fact. And I'm sure he wouldn't mind if you had a bit of his.
Really? That would be very nice.
Come on, let's go to his house.
Oh, Pooh, you're back. Welcome home.
Hold on, dear Piglet. This here's a different Pooh. Although, he's looking more familiar a bit all the time.
But that can't be. He looks just like my friend Pooh. And I was waiting here for him to return home, and he has.
This is very strange indeed.
Well, what do you have to say for yourself, Pooh? If that's your real name.
I'm confused. But then that doesn't take much.
Well, I am Pooh, your friend, Piglet. But what are you doing over here? I'm all the way on the other side of the hill. You travel very fast for such a very small animal.
But you left just a little while ago, and I said I'd be waiting for you here. I haven't gone anywhere.
But I believe I haven't finished my adventure.
Really? It's still going on? How's it going?
Well, I don't know. You see, first I walked and walked and walked, and then I walked up this big hill.
Go on! And then what? And then what?
And then I saw this lovely butterfly.
Please go on!
And the butterfly flew round and round.
Go on!
And then it flew away, so I followed it back down the other side of the hill.
Oh, go on!
And then I met all of you, and you all remind me of my very dearest friends, and... This is all making my brain hurt a bit.
My dear Pooh, if I may call you that, it seems that perhaps you went back down the hill the same way you came up. And you are, in fact, the Pooh Bear that we all know and love.
Kinda thought he looked familiar.
Are you sure?
Well, you certainly seem like the Pooh Bear I know. Always going off on adventures, looking for honey and that sort of thing.
Well, now that you mention it, I did turn around a number of times. I guess I was here all along.
I'm sorry you didn't get to have your adventure, Pooh.
Oh, but I did, Piglet. Because, you know, I got to meet all my very best friends all over again.
Welcome home, Pooh. Pity about the other rabbit. I would have liked to have met him.
And that is the story of how Pooh went on an adventure, only to find that sometimes the best adventures are in your own backyard. And where he also learned even our most familiar, favorite friends and places can become new all over again.
If you can see them in a new way.
Exactly, Piglet.
Hello, hello. Come here, little journal book thingy that you write and sing. Come on, wherever you are.
Tigger, I do believe...
Oh, dear Tigger, you seem to be making an awful mess. And it was so clean in here before.
What, this? I am not making a mess. I am doing a very scientific search. It's just so much harder to find stuff when it's all put away, you know. Now, let me see.
Well, Tigger, why don't I read another story while we're waiting? The one about Piglet looks interesting.
Oh, good idea there, Mr. Narrator. Please read away.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Narrator. Please do. I'd love to hear a story about me.
All right, now let's see. Piglet. Oh, yes, I do think you'll like this one. One fine day, Piglet was strolling happily down a path. Little did he suspect that excitement was just about the corner.
He means me. Don't thank me. That was my special good morning pounce, Piglet. No time to chase lounge around. I gotta go, little guy.
Where are you going, Tigger?
I gotta hit the road, little Butteroony. I'm here in the call of the wild.
Call of the wild?
Oh, yeah. Once a year, I go off on a long explore by myself, just to sharpen my jungle instincts. And I growl at the moon, run with the pack. You know, that kind of stuff.
But Tigger, who will bounce and pounce and other Tiggery things? I'll miss you.
Really? You will? Holy Cleveland! I never thunk of that. You're right. I couldn't possibly leave the 100-acre woods tiggerless.
What do we do?
Well, I'll have to find a replacement. But who? After all, I'm the only one. What about you, Piglet? Could you be the new me? Just for a while.
Me? Oh, yes, I'd love to be you. After all, tiggers are such large, bouncy animals, and piglets are so small and unbouncy.
Splendiferous! Then we'll start the RTTP, Death Rigorous Tiggerous Training Program, right away! This is the first phase of your training, better known as bouncing. Show me what you got, Piglet. Well, what you need is to get more air between you and the old ground. Wait a minute. I got just a thing. There! Finished!
Well, all right.
Oh, I guess I forgot to tell you about the coming down part. I like to call phase two talking the talk. We'll start with an easy one. Say, ridiculous.
Ridiculous.
No, you're adding the wrong consonants. Ridiculous with a rus on the end. You nut.
Ridiculous.
Ah, better. If you get into trouble, Bibbo, just tell him you got Larry's jitis. phase two is over, now on to phase three. Pouncing is how you greet people. It's fun, surprising, and folks just love it.
I'm not so sure about that, Tigger.
You don't have to be. I am. Here, I'll show you. Come up behind me. Shout, and pounce on me. Go ahead, go ahead. Oh, boy. What a surprise. Thanks. That pounce just made my whole day brighter.
Oh, you're just trying to be nice. I don't make a very good Tigger, do I?
Oh, now what kind of talk is that, my little pig Tigger Latini? I guess I haven't told you the most important thing about being a Tigger.
Well, what's that?
Your mental altitude.
Don't you mean mental attitude?
No, I mean altitude. If you wanna talk the talk and walk the walk, if you wanna bounce the bounce and pounce the pounce, let your thinking fly way up high. You'll soon see why, 'cause there's no doubt it's all about mental altitude. You gotta have a Tiggerific mental altitude.
But I don't even look like a Tigger.
If you haven't got stripes, no need to run and hide. You can still be a guy who wears his stripes inside. And just knowing the stripes are there will make you dare to try and find a Tiggerish kind of mental altitude. A bouncer-ish Tiggeristic mental altitude.
Well, I don't know.
It's confidentiality that makes a piglet roar. What else could whaleify a mere sardine? So rev your thinking engine up and watch your spirit soar. You'll see the world will be a trampoline. And then you'll talkerate a talk.
And walkify the walk.
Come on and bouncelate a bounce.
And pouncetize the pounce.
And I think that you'll find you'll be a lot like me if day and night you keep the right mental altitude.
Mental altitude.
A bumptious, scrumptious, tiggerific mental altitude.
Mental altitude.
A joyful, umptious, tiggertastic, pouncish, pouncish, quite elastic, jumpalicious, bumperastic mental altitude. You have earned your stripes, young Tiglet. Rise, Sir Tigger Replacement. Go forth and pounce. Okay, I gotta go. To call it a wild waste for no Tigger, but you are gonna do great, TTFN.
TTFN? Well, here goes nothing.
Hello? Who's there?
It's me, Tiglet. T-I-double-glet. Oh, dear. I hope I didn't harm you, Rabbit. If so, I apologize most sincerely.
What are you doing, Piglet?
Oh, well, you see, I'm the new replacement for Tigger.
But why?
T-H-T-L-F-A-F-T.
What does that mean?
Tigger had to leave for a few days.
Piglet, why don't you just go back to being yourself?
Don't be ridiculous, old furry bunny type person with ears. Ooh.
Oh, please, Piglet, just call me by my real name, all right?
Oh, all right. Sorry, Rabbit.
Meanwhile, elsewhere in the woods, Tigger realized he had forgotten his toothbrush.
Fresh breath is very important when you're prowling the jungle.
So he rushed back home to get it.
Oh, look. Piglet's hanging out with old long ears. Make me proud, little Tiglet.
So you think I'm a bad replacement, Rabbit?
Oh, no, Piglet. No, you're doing a fine job. In fact, if you'd like to know the truth, I wish the real Tigger were a bit more smart and polite like you.
Do my ears deceive me? Floppy Ears thinks I'm a terrible Tigger.
Piglet.
Oh, who would have thunk a Piglet would be a better Tigger than a Tigger? Oh, it's all over for me. I probably wouldn't even make a good Piglet.
Oh, hello, Tigger. What are you doing back so soon?
Oh, I'm just stopping by to say hello so I could say goodbye, I'm afraid. You'll be leaving the 100-acre wood for good, little buddy.
Leave? Oh, but why?
Well, because that's what washed up tickets do best. You're the new Stripes in town, kid. Enjoy the ride. Oh.
Oh, Fuzz. That's my favorite rake, too. Okay, up they go. Dad. One, two, three. Help me! Help me! Get Tigger!
Great idea!
Hang on, Rabbit! Help me! Tigger! Help! Rabbit is in trouble! You have to bounce and save him!
Oh, who needs a washed-up Hath Benjamin? You do it, Piglet. You're the new Tigger on the block.
But I'm much too small to bounce high enough. Hey, come on, Tigger.
Where's that old mental altitude? That very happy Tiggery mental altitude? That joyful-ific, very-ific, really-ific?
You know what I mean.
That mental altitude.
Oh, help! Help!
Don't lose your grip, old long ears. Tigger is on the job.
Oh, dear. Oh, my. Thank you, Tigger.
Ah, shucks. Twert nothing.
I must say, Tigger, even if you do pounce on me and ruin my garden, being a Tigger is indeed what you do best.
And I think I'll leave the bouncing and pouncing to the expert from now on.
It's good to be back, fellas. And front, and forward, and sideways, and up and down, too, for that matter. Well, gotta run, TGFN.
Oh, well. Tiggers will be Tiggers, I suppose.
Yes, isn't it wonderful?
Ta-ta-too, ta-ta-poing, and a ding, and a ho, and a hoo.
And that is the story of the day Piglet was a Tigger for a day and found that every one of us is unique, which means that we're each special in our own way. We each have our own way of talking, thinking.
And bouncing, because I'm the only one, you know.
Yes, Tigger, it's true. But we're each and every one of us the only one.
Even me?
Yes, Piglet.
Hey, where have you guys been? I've been flying around everywhere looking for you.
We've been waiting for Christopher Robin, and we're reading stories he's marked with bookmarks about each one of us. The first one was about me.
Really? Is there one about me?
Why, yes, there is, Kessie. It's right here. Mr. Narrator.
At your service. A story about our little bluebird friend, Kessie. Ah, yes, here we go. One fine day in the 100-acre wood, Kessie was flying about looking for... Well, what are you looking for, Kessie?
Oh, hi. I was looking around to see if any of my friends need any help. I'm a good helper.
Why, that's very nice of you.
Thanks. Hey, do you need any help today? Like with the story or something?
Why, thank you, Kessie. But I think the story seems to be running smoothly so far.
Okay. I'm gonna go look for somebody else to help then, okay?
Good idea, Kessie. And so, off she went to find someone to help.
Hi, Pooh. What's up?
Up? Well, it appears that we are up, Kessie. But we must be very quiet, or the bees will discover that I'm trying to get a smackerel of honey from their hive. I don't know why, but it seems to upset them.
Oh, I didn't know that. Can I help, Pooh?
I think I'd better do this on my own, Kessie. It takes a lot of honey getting know-how to know how to get honey from a hive. Thank you anyway, though.
Okay. Gee,
doesn't need my help either. Oh, well. Maybe Rabbit does. Hi, Rabbit. What are you doing?
I'm weeding my garden, dear.
Can I help Rabbit, please?
Well, I don't know, Kessie. In order to weed properly, you must have knowledge of gardening.
Oh.
You must be able to distinguish a weed from...
Ah, Kessie, no!
That isn't a weed, my dear. That's the top of a carrot. You mustn't pull that out. Oh, goodness, no.
I'm sorry, Rabbit. I just wanted to help.
Oh, no. That's quite all right, dear. Why don't you just run along and enjoy yourself?
I can't help anybody. How can I get to know stuff so I can help my friends? I know. I'll find Owl. He knows everything. Hello, Owl.
I don't want any, thank you.
It's me, Kessie.
Hello, Kessie. What can I do for you?
I want to know lots and lots of stuff, Owl. In fact, I want to know everything. Can you help me learn stuff?
But, my dear, knowledge is everywhere. One must simply be out in the world and contemplate what you see around you. Knowledge will come to you eventually.
Really? You mean knowledge will just come to me? That's so easy.
Yes, my dear. Now run along. I have some important, work to do.
Thanks, Owl.
And so, Kessie found a good spot and waited for knowledge to come to her. And she waited. And she waited. And she waited.
Okay, knowledge! Where are you anyway? Hello? I'm waiting. I'm here. Nothing. Maybe I'm not doing it right. Owl, it's me again. Kessie, could I talk to you for another minute, please?
My word. Doesn't anyone around here know I'm nocturnal? Yes, Kessie.
It didn't work. I sat out there for a long time. But I still don't know anything. What did I do wrong?
Oh, but Kessie, my dear, you misunderstood me. I meant that one must live and experience. Then, over time, bit by bit, knowledge comes to you.
But I want to know now.
Tell me, Kessie, what is it that you want to know?
I want to know it all like you do.
I do.
Be grown up and tall, like on my tippy toes, so I can spread my wings.
Be patient, you'll do that and a million other things.
But when do you suppose I want to know everything now? See, I'm ready to stand on my own. Ow, I know that I'm little, but teach me the riddle. I want to know everything now. Yeah, I want to know everything now.
Everything now? Everything is an awful lot.
Oh, I want to know everything now.
Everything now.
Fly higher than I've ever flown.
You've ever flown.
Don't just keep me guessing. I'm ready for a lesson. I'm eager and open. My eyes are wide open.
I want to know everything now.
You're the wisest one in the wood, Owl. Can't you help me?
The wisest? Well, I don't know about that. But I suppose I could put off my important work until tomorrow.
Oh, thank you.
I shall teach you everything I know, Kessie. Now, the best place to start is with books. Let's see. Yes. Here we are, all about birds.
Know thyself, as the wise man once said. There are all sorts of interesting tidbits in here.
Like what?
Well, for instance, it says here that birds have remarkable eyesight and can see a great distance and have an amazing sense of direction.
Huh. I can do all that. That's interesting, I guess.
Well, that's all for today.
That's all? But that's just one little bit of knowledge, Owl. I need to know lots more.
I think you'll find a little knowledge goes a long way, Cassie. Now, off you go.
Hello, Cassie.
Hi, you guys.
And where are you off to?
Well, Owl's teaching me to be as wise as he is.
Oh, how exciting.
Yeah. Anyway, I just had my first lesson, and Owl said I should take a walk through the wood.
Oh, a walk in the wood. Mind if I tag along with you, Cassie?
That'd be great.
Oh, yes. I'd like to come, too.
Me three. I feel like bouncing a little after that taste-delicious lunch.
And so the friends walked until it was time to turn around and go home. The question now facing them was, which path was the path home?
We're lost! And it'll be dark soon.
I don't care for these woods when it gets dark. You know, because it's bad for my bones when I can't see where my feetsies are landing.
What are we going to do?
I wish I knew.
What we need is somebody with a good sense of direction.
Or somebody who could somehow see very far down these paths so that we could find out which one has home at the other end of it.
Hey, wait a minute. I know what to do. I can help us.
But how, Cassie?
Well, I'll just fly up really high. I can see everything from up there, so I'll be able to look down the paths and see which is the way home.
What's all the fuss about?
We got lost in the wood, and Cassie got us unlost.
Oh, Owl, I could see for miles and miles, so when I flew up high, I could see the way home. Just like in your book all about birds.
Good for you, Cassie. As I said, a little knowledge goes a long way.
But I still have so much to learn.
Well, what's wrong with knowing what you know now, and not knowing what you don't know now until later?
Oh, that's true, Pooh. Just take it one small step at a time, and you'll be fine.
You sure will. And don't go growing up too fast there, Katharini. We kind of like you how you are right now.
Really? Thanks, guys.
Ah, youth. I remember my days at Oxford as if it were yesterday. Cricket on the quadrangle, hooting from the turrets at dusk. Did I ever tell you how I took a first in swooping?
Is that right? Sheesh, and I thunk it was for talking.
And so ends the story of the day Cassie found that there are many, many things you learn in books. But with Owl's help, she also found that wisdom doesn't come in a day.
That's for sure. But I'm learning a little bit more every day.
Oh, that's wonderful, Cassie.
Christopher, is that you?
Christopher Robin!
His mother!
Well, okay. I'm over here.
Christopher, don't you have after school today?
Can you see me? Quiet.
I could have sworn I heard talking up here. Wow, this room is certainly a mess. Oh, I'll have to talk to Christopher about it when he gets home.
Wee Tigger? I think you're the one who...
Tut, tut, Piglet. This is no time for paw-pointing. We gotta do something.
I agree. We don't want Christopher Robin to get in trouble.
Hello?
Oh, greetings.
Hello,
there,
Fluffy.
Hi, Rabbit.
Oh, my word. What's going on here?
Well, we were looking for Christopher Robin.
And I started looking for his journal thingamadoodle.
That's a book where you write down your thoughts, Robin.
And then we found the book with the stories marked.
Oh, look at this bookmark with a picture of me. Well, this story looks fascinating. I'm sure you haven't read anything this good yet.
Well,
read.
All right. A story for our floppy-eared friend. Oh, yes, this is one of my favorites as well. On one fine spring day in the 100-acre wood, Rabbit was doing what he did every spring, planting seeds for his garden.
Ah, yes. Here you go, little radish seed. A nice, warm place to grow. Oh, what was that? The wind?
Wind? Why, no, I'd say it's more of a Tiggernado.
Tigger! My radish seeds! Look what you've done! Ooh, that's it! I can't take this pouncing anymore. Just stay away from me, Tigger!
Hey, old long ears! Where you going? We were just starting to have fun!
Hi, Tigger!
Oh, how you doing there, Katharini? Say, you hang around old Bunny Boy a lot. So, why is he always so grumpy-ish?
Well, he isn't always grumpy. Why do you ask?
Oh, nothing. I just gave Rabbit a little good morning pounce, and it seemed like he might have got mad at me. It's probably nothing, though.
Well, Tigger, Rabbit didn't happen to be doing his spring planting, did he?
Well, yeah, he sure was. You should have seen them little seedies go flying. What?
Well, it might have bothered him.
Hold on a minuet. You mean old Floppy Ears thinks that I'm a bother?
Sometimes, Tigger.
Well, why didn't somebody tell me? I gotta do something about this. I gotta go over there right now and make friends with Rabbit again. You got any ideas how to do that?
Well, you could try taking an interest in something Rabbit really likes. Like gardening, for instance.
You mean he actually likes hoeing and planting and whatever it is he does over there? You know, I thought that was just how he waited around for me to pounce him.
No, actually, gardening is his favorite thing.
Well, what do you know? Thanks, Katharini!
No problem, Tigger. Good luck. See you later.
Hey, Bunny Boy! How's about coming out here and teaching me all about seeds and frankenfertilizers and stuff?
Oh, no, Tigger. I know you. This is just some plot so you can bounce me again. Well, I'm not falling for it.
Oh, this guy playing hard to get. I know how to get him. Okay, then. I'll just learn all about gardening on my own. This looks like a good spot for a garden.
No. Oh, Tigger. Seeds can't grow in soil that's so rough and dry.
Huh. I guess gardening isn't what Tiggers do best. So, show me how, Garden Boy. Everybody knows that you are the bestest at making plants grow and stuff.
Well, I don't know.
Oh, come on!
Well, no, oh, all right. But just remember, gardening should be fun.
Fun I can do.
Well, we're going to have to get you seeds, tools, and of course a patch of ground. Oh, here! This is perfect! Plenty of sunlight, lots of moisture, dark, rich earth.
Well, yeah, but...
Now, you'll need a watering can. No. This one is too small and rusty. Take my good one.
All I want to know is...
And I just bought a brand new shovel you can use. It's in the...
Rabbit! When do we start...
Well, first you must poke a hole in the soil, then you drop in the seed and cover it over. A little water and voila.
foil, poke, drop, and soak. Got it. A boodle dee da, doo doo doo. A boo boo diddle dee dee dee. Da boo boo, cheek boo boom, happy dee dee dee.
Tater, what do you think you're doing?
Planting a garden, just like you said. So now what, long ears?
Now you wait for the seeds to sprout.
Gotcha. So how long? What, 2-3 minutes, what?
Try several weeks. Right now, the seeds are dormant. That means they're asleep. And it takes them a while to wake up.
Asleep, huh? Well, this ought to wake them up sooner. Every vine upon the wall had to somehow learn to crawl by starting out real small with just a little pose. You take it nice and slow. Never know why even friendships can start to get growing.
Rabbit was so flattered by Tigger's interest in gardening, he decided to help his striped friend in any way he could. He showed Tigger which weeds to pull. He gladly gave Tigger anything he needed from his valuable garden supplies. After which, however, he often found he had little left for himself, but Rabbit didn't care. And Tigger, of course, was very happy. After all, he and Rabbit were spending a lot of time together. Things seemed to be going well indeed. That is, until the time came for the gardens to sprout, and Tigger's, not surprisingly, came up quite a bit faster than Rabbit's.
Hello, Tigger. Piglet and I thought it would be nice to see how your new garden was coming.
Here, buddy, my vegetables are already ripe. Try one.
Oh, these are so big and juicy looking.
Hey, Tigger, how goes the gardening?
Oh, just great. Boy, is old Floppy Ears ever gonna be proud. Here he comes now. Hey, Rabbit, try one of my curly carrots. I grew it special for you.
Well, say, this is wonderful. My carrots aren't even close to being ready.
Yeah? So what's your point, bunny buddy of mine? That you're pleased as Punch and Judy about my gardening ability? Is that it?
What? Oh, yes, of course, Tigger. Congratulations. You're obviously a terrific gardener. Maybe the best gardener in the whole 100-acre wood.
Huh. I wonder what's wrong with Bunny Boy now. I thought he'd be happy with me for once, but he's all droopy. Hey, Rabbit, wait up! listen, about the garden.
Oh, what is it, Tigger? Haven't I already told you how wonderful it is? All right, you're obviously a better gardener than me, Tigger. Happy?
Rabbit, if you just listen at me for a second. Look, pal, you can have my part of the garden. You're the reason it's as good as it is anyway.
What?
Sure. You helped me pull weeds, you gave me the best plot of land, all your plant food and your gardening tools, and you even told me what to do.
But
besides, I was only doing it so we could spend some quality time becoming better friends.
You what?
Oh, yeah. I must not have done a very good job at it, though. You're just as grumpy at me as ever.
Oh, no, 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 Tigger. You did a wonderful job. I'm the one who messed this up. I guess I never thought you'd go to all this trouble just to make me feel good.
Oh, come on. You gotta be kidding. Why do you think I pounced you more than anybody else?
I never thought of it that way. But I'm really touched, Tigger. Thank you.
You're welcome. Well, guess I'll see you around then.
Oh, Tigger, wait. I was wondering, do you think you could show me that growing dance of yours?
Oh, yeah, sure. You really want to see it?
Oh, definitely. It seems like I have a lot of things I need to learn.
You sure do. I mean, you know, in a good way, of course.
And so, Tigger and Rabbit talked far into the afternoon. They talked of many things, of friendship and fertilizer. Thus ends the story of the day Rabbit taught Tigger how to garden, and Tigger taught Rabbit a little something about friendship as well.
What a great story! It's all about me.
But that was about me, Tigger.
Well, I don't know if you had something blocking up those floppy ears of yours, but it sure seemed to be about me to me.
Tigger, here. I think I just found your story. Look.
Oh, yeah. You're right, buddy boy. That does kind of look like me. Oh, Mr. Narrator.
All right. Although, I do think we should do something about this room soon.
Me too.
Shh. All right, on with our story. Ah, yes, I remember this one well. It was long past bedtime in the 100-acre wood, and everyone was fast asleep. Except for Tigger. Tigger, isn't it past your bedtime?
Nah, see, I realized while I was getting ready for old Betty Pie that, you know, stuff was probably happening while I was asleep. Tiggers don't like missing stuff did when you're sleeping. So, I decided to give up sleeping.
I see, Tigger.
Yeah, so what do you think we ought to do for the first thing of the... Well, I guess he's not a nighty-time guy like me. I bet old Rabbit's up to something good. That fluff bottom probably never sleeps.
I'm coming. This better be important. I was just dreaming about a carrot as big as a house.
Oh, what could be more important than hanging out with your old friend Tigger?
Tigger, do you know what time it is?
Oh, well, actually, we know. I'm not too good with them clocky thingamabobs, but from the looks of how dark it is, I'd say it's, pretty late. But what's that to us, right? Nighttime's when all the fun happens.
No. Nighttime is bedtime. Time to go to sleep. So go to sleep, Tigger. Good night.
Oh, I get it. A little napping before the real fun starts. Well, I'm not sleeping, so I'll just sit here and watch while you sleep. Go ahead.
But...
Don't worry, bunny buddy. Your snoring won't bother me. It's kind of entertaining, actually.
All right. Just be quiet, Tigger, please. I need my beauty sleep.
You can say that again. Sorry.
Tigger?
Sorry some more.
I'll never get to sleep with you staring at me.
Great! Because I gotta tell you, you're kind of a boring sleeper.
I can see I need some help with this. Yeah, maybe Piglet can do something with you.
Yeah, Pigoletto's probably dancing the night away.
Who could be at my door so very, very late at night? Heffalumps and woozles. Oh, no. They'd like to come in through the window. Oh, maybe it's something polite and even more ferocious.
Hello, Piglet old pal. Are you home or what?
Oh, dear. It's eating Tigger.
Come, Piglet, open up.
And Rabbit, too. Oh, my. Oh, dear. I must do something. One, two, three.
Hello, Piglet.
What you up to? Oh, well, look at that. You see, Rabbit, I told you Piglet would be doing something neat.
Yes.
So what are you playing there, little Piggy? Spaceman? Gladiators? Space Gladiator Man?
Oh, no. Actually, I was just a little bit nervous. But is everything all right, Tigger? What are you doing so very up, so very late at night?
Oh, no, Piggy. I'm giving up sleeping forever is all. I don't want to miss anything you party guys are doing while I'm asleep.
Piglet, please, you've got to help me. Don't you see? If Tigger gives up sleep, we all do. None of us will ever sleep again. And I need to sleep, Piglet, very badly.
I'll try to help, Rabbit, if I can.
So, fellas, what are we doing? The night's young.
No, it isn't.
I know. How about a nice, soothing bedtime story?
Oh, what a wonderful idea, Piglet.
Yeah, I know a great one. Gather around, buddy boys, gather around. This here tale is about to spin. And just then, the horrible monstrous toothbrush brushed everyone in sight. And then it brushed the buildings, and then the mountains. And then it spit and rinsed in the ocean. And then do you know what it did?
No.
It got out the dental floss.
Oh.
You know, that story was invigorizing. What next? A game of bounce to bunny? Oh, boy, who knew you guys were having so much fun while I was sleeping? Silly me.
Oh, dear.
We'll never get to sleep now. We must find Pooh. He'll know what to do.
Perfect. Let's get Pooh Boy in on the fun.
Honey.
Hey, Buddy Bear, what you doing?
Sleeping, or I was at least until a moment ago.
Well, not anymore, you're not. Sleeping is for the birds. That reminds me, we're gonna go wake up Al and Kessie.
You've got to help us, Pooh. We've got to get him to sleep.
We tried a bedtime story, but it just woke him up even more.
Not to mention us.
Honey, anyone? It's just that a small smackerel always seems to relax me.
That's it, Pooh Bear.
I should eat more, honey?
No, we have to make Tigger relax in a Tiggery sort of way. Excuse me, Tigger, could you stop bouncing for a minute?
Sure, Piglet-o. So, fellas, what's next on the old agenda? Skydiving, tag, bacon brownies, what?
Well, no, actually, well, we were just wondering, Tigger, is there anything that makes you, stop bouncing and relax, you know, just for a second?
No. Bounce is what Tiggers do best, you little nut. Although, there was something.
What? What?
Well, it was just something my good old stripedy nursemaid used to do.
Yes?
Oh, tell us, Tigger, please.
Well, she...
Yes?
She always used to sing me a lullaby.
Oh.
I could still hear her off-key voice as if it was yesterday. She can't sing a note, you know.
Well, perhaps we could sing you a lullaby, Tigger.
Really,
yes,
for real?
Yes, of course we could. What a wonderful idea. A Tigger's lullaby.
Curl up with your pillows and your blankie. Close your eyes and dream so soft and hazy.
Go to sleep before you make us cranky.
it soon or else we'll all go crazy.
Night is falling in the stripy skies. That means it's time to close your stripy eyes. Tigger, please lay down your stripy head and rest your stripes upon your stripy bed.
The trouble as we see it, Tigger, is these problematic hours that you keep.
You like to bounce and boing and whoop and whiz, while everybody else would like to sleep.
Dream of leafy vegetables in neat and tidy rows.
Dream of crushing woozles with your great big stripy toes.
Dream of eating honey and drinking honey too.
Dream a dream you're dreaming that you dream the whole night through.
It's time to stop the noise and start the silence. We really can't abide another peep. So gaze upon the inside of your eyelids. Lay down your Tigger stripes and go to sleep. Lie down and sleep. Please, Tigger, sleep. Just go to sleep.
I guess I am a little sleepy. Oh, but Pooh Boy, I don't want to be left out of anything fun.
Oh, don't worry, Tigger. We're all sleeping when you're asleep. Nothing happens. Just a bit of snoring.
Oh, well. Why didn't you just say that in the beginning, Rabbit? Well, good night, I suppose.
Why didn't I? But I can't. Oh.
Good to see Rabbit didn't have any trouble getting back to sleep.
Oh, yes, it is, Piglet. Now, let's be off. We'd better get to sleep as well. Master Narrator. Master Narrator.
Oh, hello, Pooh.
The story's over now.
And that is the story of Pooh. What exactly happened tonight?
Oh, it's all right, Mr. Narrator. You can go back to sleep.
Thank you, Pooh.
Oh, you're quite welcome.
Oh, my. I seem to have slept through that one. It's just that particular story always makes me so sleepy.
Oh, don't sweat it, Mr. Narrator Rooney, old chum. I remember what I learned. I learned that there's nothing much happening at nighty time, so you might as well get some sleep.
And we learned that for putting Tiggers to sleep, a lullaby, that's a bedtime song, is always very nice.
Oh, well, thank you for remembering.
I think that was the front door. Everybody, quick! We've got to clean up!
Watch out!
What about me, huh? Head figures.
Oh, no, Eeyore, we didn't forget. We just weren't remembering.
But Eeyore, Christopher Robin didn't forget about you. Look, there's a bookmark with you on it, too.
Well, Mr. Narrator, if it's not too much trouble.
But Christopher Robin is going to be here any minute.
Just my luck. It is too much trouble.
All right, then. A story for Eeyore. Ooh, let's see now. Oh, yes, this one's quite surprising, as I remember. It was a special day in the 100-acre wood as everyone was getting ready for a surprise party for Eeyore's birthday.
Whoa, Mr. Narrator! Back up there, fella! You need to reconsiderate what you're saying.
Excuse me, Tigger?
He's saying it's not Eeyore's birthday today.
Isn't it Eeyore's birthday? But I thought...
You see, it's not Eeyore's birthday. It's his tail-iversary.
His tail-iversary. What is a tail-iversary?
It's kind of like his tail's birthday.
In fact, it's the anniversary of the day Eeyore's tail got attached to him.
Or the day he got attached to his tail.
So you're having a surprise party for Eeyore's tail-iversary. How exciting.
Yes, that's right, and we have a lot to do to get ready. So let's stop all this chattering and get started. Now, first off, I want to make sure that everyone knows how to keep the surprise in your surprise party. Now, with that in mind, I've made up the following list of things to remember. Number one, don't tell Eeyore that we're having a surprise party for him. Number two, don't let it slip that we're planning a party for Eeyore to Eeyore himself. Number three, make sure Eeyore doesn't find out about the surprise party. Everyone got it?
What was number two again?
All right. If we could just continue. Owl and Kessie, you're in charge of Eeyore's gift.
Splendid.
Pooh and Piglet, you do the decorations. And Tigger, I'll probably regret this, but you and I will bake the cake.
Now you're talking.
Let's go, Pooh.
And remember, don't tell Eeyore.
Meanwhile, Eeyore was in another part of the wood, completely unaware of what was going on.
Here I am, alone again, and on my tailiversary, too. Typical. Well, Tail, guess it's just you and me. Happy tailiversary. Thanks for sticking with me all these years. Not much of a talker, are you? Sure is quiet. Be nice to have someone to talk to besides my tail. No offense. Well, guess I'll go see where everybody is.
Gosh, this present sure looks pretty, Owl. I can't wait to see Eeyore's face when we all jump out and yell surprise!
Low, Owl. Low, Kessie.
Oh, dear! Hello.
Hello, Eeyore.
Something the matter? You guys look a little funny.
The matter? Why, nothing. We're fine as fine can be.
Yeah, fine. Just fine.
What can we do for you, Eeyore?
Just thought I'd come by, have a chat.
A chat.
Guess I can't really think of anything to say.
Well, then, it was nice to see you.
Yeah, nice.
Yep, okay. Guess I'll be on my way. Oh, well. Maybe somebody else will feel like talking.
Oh, that was a close call. Eeyore almost saw a...
Oh, dear.
...present. Oh, dear.
Oh, I'm certainly glad we got to do the decorations, aren't you, Piglet?
Yes.
You know, there's nothing I like better than blowing up a balloon. How about you?
Oh, yes. I have to agree with you about that, but could you help me down?
Yes, of course, Piglet.
Oh, no, Pooh. Eeyore's walking this way. We've got to do something and fast. If he sees us here with all these decorations, he's sure to figure out that we're throwing him a party.
Quite right, Piglet. Oh, goodness. I'm afraid my mind's a blank.
Oh, I've got an idea.
Oh, hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Don't believe we've met.
Well, it's... You see, we're... We are,
Balloon heads.
Pleased to meet you. My name's Eeyore. Say, looks like you're having a party.
Yes, we and other balloon head friends
are having a balloon head party.
Well, guess it ought to be a good party if everyone who's coming is a balloon.
Yes, that's what we thought too.
Yep. Well, guess I'll go look for my other friends. See ya.
Goodbye.
Bye.
Oh, it worked. We saved the surprise, Piglet.
There's just one thing, Pooh.
Which one thing, Piglet?
Now all the balloons for Eeyore's party have strange faces on them.
Oh, yes. Bother.
Frosting's almost done! Oh, I sure hope Eeyore likes to see Cake-a-Rooney.
Oh, I'm sure he will, Tigger. And the best part is how surprised he'll be when he sees it. If everyone keeps quiet, of course.
Dee's lips are sealed, bunny boy. Why, nothing could make me talk. See?
Well, you can be sure that I won't talk either. If there's one thing I know, it's how to keep a surprise a surprise.
What surprise?
Eeyore! Hello! Look, Tigger, look, it's Eeyore. We were just talking about you. And nothing to do with the surprise, though. I mean, not about the fact that it's your tail event. I mean...
Hey, hop on a little frosting, floppy toes.
What's the cake for?
Cake? Ooh, that cake. Well, see, it's for dessert, naturally.
Dessert.
What he's trying to say is, we just thought we'd have something special like for dessert.
Oh, special.
Glad somebody's having something special. I wish something special would happen to me, but nothing ever does. Guess nobody cares.
Aw, don't be so glum, old pal. You know, we all care about you lots and lots.
You do? I thought everybody forgotten about me.
Forgotten about you? You gotta be kidding. Why, Eeyore, old pal, don't you understand what this is all about? It's all for your tail.
Do you think the frosting is done, Tigger? It seems a bit chocolatey to me.
Oh, boy. Cake. Decorations. If you didn't know any better, you'd think there was some kind of a party.
Well, I...
You know, you guys are gonna run out of frosting if you keep going like this. Oh, see you later. Guess everybody forgot about my tail-iversary.
Psst, Eeyore! I'm glad I found you. Would you come over here for a minute?
Sure thing, Piglet.
Surprise!
It isn't pink and curly.
Or sensible and white.
It isn't big and bouncy.
But it's just exactly right.
Have a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary. Happy tail forever, may it wag. Have a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary. Keep it swinging, never let it sag.
Hail, oh hail, unto your splendid tail.
Decorated with a bow
and fastened with a nail.
It has a certain elegance no other tail can match.
And when it does fall off, it's not that hard to reattach.
With a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary, and we wish you many, many more. With a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary,
even if you don't exactly know what it is for.
With a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary, happy, happy, keep it shiny and on your hiney, and now we finally get into the song.
Woohoo! So, were you surprised, buddy? Were you?
Had no idea. You guys are good. So all these decorations are for me.
Yes, we had to pretend to be balloon heads.
So that's why all the balloons have smiley faces on them, you see.
Best cheerful looking decorations I've ever seen.
Here's your present, Eeyore. I'm afraid it got a little crumpled.
Well, you came by and we had to sit on it to hide it.
A new bow for my tail. It's very pretty. Thanks, guys.
And here's the cake. We ran out of frosting, unfortunately.
Yeah, on account it's easier to keep from blabbing when your mouth is full.
Oh, that's okay. Who needs frosting when you've got such great friends?
Okay, everybody, one more time.
Have a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary. Happy tail forever, may it brag. Have a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary. Keep it swinging, never let it sag. With a happy, happy, happy tail-iversary, and we wish you many, many more.
And that is the surprising tale of the day Eeyore's friends threw him a surprise party for his tail-iversary. It certainly was a day to remember.
What a wonderful story.
And what a wonderful party. I think it's very clear what we all learned there. When throwing a party, it's very important to make a list of things to do.
Oh, yes. Lists are quite helpful when you have things to remember.
Party wouldn't have been the same without it.
Oh, Christopher, you're home.
Hi, Mom.
Watch out. Everybody, start picking up.
Oh, boy.
Didn't you clean up for me, Sporty? I thought I did. Let's go see.
That's strange. I guess I made a mistake.
Oh, that's okay, Mom.
You did clean up, and you did a great job, too. Well, you know, dinner's almost ready, so why don't you come down in a few minutes, okay?
Sure, Mom.
Okay.
All right, guys. What's been going on around here?
Oh, Christopher, there you are. We were quite worried about you.
Oh, I had soccer practice after school today.
Oh, yeah.
I do every week.
Oh, well, there you go. I was just looking for your journal to tell us where you might be. Yes, because as you know, you write everything you do down in your journal. We just thought we could look up today and find out how everything was going for you. How is it going, Christopher?
Oh, Pooh, you silly old bear. I have my journal right here. I couldn't write down what happens until it happens, could I?
I never thought of that.
Well, what'll we do now, Christopher Robin?
Well, I've marked all my favorite stories to read you before dinner. Hey, where are they? Oh,
Christopher Robin, we already did that.
Oh, really?
Sorry. I just got a fantastical idea. Christopher, why don't you read to us out of your journal?
Oh, yes. Tell us the story of your day.
What a great idea. Come on, we'll sit on the bed and read it.
And so ends the story of the day everyone waited for Christopher Robin to return home and learned...
That a journal is something you write the story of your day in. But not until after your day happens, of course.
Oui, Christopher Robin. Stories are very nice.
Right, you are, little
pig. Oh, very true, Penny.
Come on, Christopher, read to us.
Oui, Christopher Robin.
Yeah. Okay, everybody. It all began with a nice breakfast of toast with honey and some orange juice.
I like this story already.
What? No marshmallows?
Then I got ready for school.